Playoff will be for sure. That I'm not questioning at all. We are going to make
Nice
the playoff
confidence.
like every year.
कोई हार्ड इच नहीं है।
Hello and welcome to another episode of Cricket Talks. Today we have Shiv Udipi, who's a very big CSK fan and a travel blogger with us. So welcome, Shiv Udipi.
Thank you. Pleasure to be
Shiv.
Here.
So like our first question is always, since when did you start supporting CSK and why exactly did you start supporting CSK?
I started supporting in 2009-10. And that was the first time I saw CSK ka jersey and then the team and all of that. And at that time, I think we had some of the, you know, old legends like Mackay Antini and Matthew Hayden and Stephen Fleming and all of them. So at that time, and plus I was a Dhoni fan since 2007-8. So ever since that happened, I was a supporter of CSK.
Right, Dhoni. I think Dhoni was a big factor for all CSK fans starting out.
Yeah.
Right.
Especially at that time, the first two seasons, Mumbai ka team was not doing very good. So then I was like, what team should I actually like be supporting? So then I liked this team and I was anyways a Dhoni fan. So then I started supporting them.
Right.
So Shiv, considering the IPL is in UAE and since the team has arrived in UAE, CSK has been the most problematic team, like right from Ryan Ali leaving, players testing COVID positive, and now Bhaji also backing out. How do you think this will impact their chances this season?
This season, I'm not sure. It's like a 50-50 thing. Playoff will be for sure. That I'm not questioning at all. We are going to make
nice
the playoff like every year.
कोई हार्ड इच नहीं है।
हार्ड हार्ड हार्ड। Playoff confidence like anything.
Yeah. It's like, anyway, some of the other person in the team always performs in the end and like we make through. Even like some seasons we were almost on the fifth place and then last match maybe scored or did some like net run rate thing and got in. So that's like a big factor of the team. But the other thing is that Raina is like, you know, the core. It's like, that's the identity. Dhoni and Raina are the like the big two of the team. So when Raina goes away, it's like, as a fan, you're very disappointed. As the team, I don't know, because in the last season, Raina was not a very big factor. Like, if you put someone else who's also like very consistent, then maybe you can change the batting order a bit, shuffle it, and then make it work. Bhaji, I'm not that worried about because last season also, they used to play Bhaji only like 6 matches out of the 14. That too, that was at the home turf because it used to turn a lot in Chennai Stadium. So that's why I'm not that worried about Bhaji. And plus, we have a very nice replacement for him, which is Piyush Chawla. So I don't mind the leaving of Bhaji. But Raina is it's a disappointment for the fans. And like the team has also left us on social media like very blank. We don't know what has happened.
Let's talk about the upcoming season. Just tell, like, you threw light on the fact about CSK making it to the playoffs year after year. What do you think has worked for CSK for 12 years? I mean, there are teams which celebrate getting to the playoffs, and then there's one team for whom it is an absolute. I was avoiding taking the name. but for a few teams, it's just a regulation. Like CSK, 12 years, that's okay, 10 years, that is absolutely insane. So, what has worked for CSK? Is it only Dhoni? I mean, what is it?
It's the captain-coach combination. And then I've like heard in a lot of interviews that the atmosphere inside of CSK is so chilled out that like nobody, no player in the team has pressure to like perform. And then because they know like they have the trust of Dhoni, who's like one of the biggest legends of the game, of the modern game. So they end up performing sometime or the other. And like the same thing happened to Watson last year. They played him for like 10 matches consistently and he didn't score a single like half century also. And then when the semi-final and the final came, like the wait was worth it, like something like that. So like the trust in the players and the atmosphere inside the team makes them believe more. And I think it's the Dhoni, Raina and all factor which is there.
Okay, so we spoke about how successful the CSK team has been. But do you think getting banned for those 2 years has like tarnished the image? Or like is one thing which will always stay with them even though being so successful?
I think it has made the strong base, the fan base stronger. Like it's evident in all the matches that you see in the away games. Like there's always yellow in the background. With any other team that you play with, you can't see that much like away support. And last time that I went to Wankhede Stadium, like there was like a whole sea of yellow around the blue. So yeah, and the only thing is that it was a big sea. You could have seen it like proper. So yeah, So what I was saying is that like we have had the support and the people were there for the players. They didn't know what was happening in the, you know, background and the scene with the management.
Basically, Shiv, you're saying that CSK has emerged stronger as a franchise instead of that being tarnished. Because that is, the blame is on the management.
All the supporters have come out, like, ever since they got banned, people, their brand value has, like, doubled, like, become very big. So, yeah.
Right. So, what do you think is going to be their playing 11 in this season, considering no Raina, no Bhajji?
Yeah, that'd be interesting.
Yeah, we would have to use like certain substitutes which we haven't used yet. So, like, I would open with Murali Vijay and Shane Watson because Watson is the best at the top instead of like putting him down the order. So, then Watson, after that, instead of Raina, we'd have to play Faf du Plessis because in South Africa, he's used to playing at number 3 and number 4. So, in that area, we can put Faf du Plessis. After that, Raidu, because Raidu is very flexible. In the last 2 seasons, he's been going back and forth. So then Raidu, then it would be confusing as per the situation. You could put MS Dhoni or Kedar Jadhav. Sometimes when the wickets fall early, I think they send the other players before. Like Dhoni has this, I don't know why, it's his way of playing that he always reserves himself in the end. So, if that happens, if the wickets fall early, then we're going to play Jadhav, then MSD, then Ravindra Jadeja. Now, this is like a new player, Sam Curran. And I'm really excited for him to be playing here because he's like young blood. And then we've seen what he can do in England and all of that is like in swinging Yorkers. So, like, I'm very... excited to see him playing instead of Bravo. To be like honest, I'm a big CSK fan. I love the like celebrations that he does and all the fanatics that he does, the catches that he takes. But I think like in the last 2 seasons, we've seen that he's become too washed up. Like you can't expect much of him and he's become like known to all the batsmen. So his like slower balls are not working anymore, which is like... a disadvantage to the team to be playing him still. So, Sam Curran. Then I would put Deepak Chahar, who is another like exciting prospect and he's shown that in the last 2 seasons and then played for India as well. So, his like opening bowling with him. Then I would put Harbhajan. Harbhajan was my like first choice, but then now I'll put Piyush Chawla, and then I would put like I want to see Josh Hazlewood play, but then most probably they're gonna play Lungi Angidi, which is the South African tall bowler. So yeah, that's my 11. But
right, so you're not playing Imran Tahir.
No, Imran Tahir will be on a flexible basis. Like, if the game requires him, he'll play. I think he's going to... Dhoni will play Imran Tahir most of the time. But then this is, like, my kind of team which I want. Because if you have Piyush Chawla, I think he's, like, an equivalent of Imran Tahir. And he's shown it in KKR.
Right. I personally think they might just go for 3 spinners. They might just go for 3 spinners instead of...
Right. It's a spinner-based team.
So, you mentioned being excited by Sam Curran. So, I was going to ask you, who is the X-Factor for you? Is he the X-Factor for CSK this year? Or is there any other player?
X-Factor is a young prospect, which I'm excited about. X-Factor, like always is MS Dhoni, because of his contribution in the middle. Last season, right. I think we were struggling in a few matches, but then his form was like over the top. So then because of him, we qualified last season. Mm-hmm. So for him, I'm very excited to see him because none of us have seen him in the last 2 years since that World Cup semi-final. But yeah, so my young prospect would be Sam Curran, and my like X factor is always MS Dhoni.
It was great having you, Shiv. Even though I don't like CSK, but it was good talking to a CSK fan. Hope you had
even
a good
time. I don't like Mumbai. So,
nobody's asking for your preferences over here. CSK.
The hate is mutual.
Correct. That's true. Yeah. And I hope that hate gives rise to a great match on the 19th.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Let's hope for a great match. It was a very insightful conversation. We had a lot of fun. Tanvir, would you like to ask him something?
Shiv, would you like to give a last message to all our viewers?
If you want to support CSK, please press the like button and subscribe. Okay.
All Mumbai Indians fans, please give a neutral message.
Mumbai Indians fans, please subscribe. Chennai Super Kings fans, please like. And they've been putting out episodes, so please watch and like subscribe.
Thank you, Shiv.
Thank you, Shiv. It was great having you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you so
Let's
much.
Hope for a great match on the 19th.
Yes.
With Mumbai winning. Bye. It's always great interacting with cricket fans and getting to know their point of views as well. If you want to join us and talk about anything related to cricket, do let us know in the comment section.
We hope you have been enjoying the content we've been putting out. For a lot more interesting and entertaining discussions about cricket, keep watching The Cricket Company.